Hi, and welcome back to a very close-up Findersbeepers history seekers with a bit of cobweb that's just bouncing about all over the place.
It might not be a cobweb.
Well, what else would
it be?
Could be
a little bit of an entity.
What, like a ghost's pube or something like that? Yeah. That's what it looks like.
Pube.
So we are in the Midlands? Yes. Why did you think about it? As soon as
I had to think where we were.
Yeah.
I couldn't remember where we'd come to.
So, yeah, we're in a little cottage. Now, it is only really small, so I'm hoping there's enough in this to make it a good video for you, but we've not looked around yet, so there could be some amazing stuff upstairs, but it's like a bungalow, isn't it? But it looks big for a bungalow.
Could be.
A dormer.
Yeah.
Don't dormers have stairs?
Yeah.
Well, then isn't that an house?
No, it's a bungalow that's been converted, the attic's been converted.
Right.
Is that right?
I think yeah. It is. I think that is right. But then does it not technically become an house?
It become a house because you've got an upstairs.
Yeah. So what is the point of a dome or bungalow? You just call it an house.
Yeah.
I had a bungalow. Now I've got an house.
Yeah. Upstairs, isn't it?
Stupid people, aren't they? They just like to add little names.
Architects, isn't it?
Exactly.
It's like, I live in a flat. No, I live in an apartment.
No, an apartment's different though, isn't it? I don't know how.
A maisonette.
No, I don't understand maisonette. What is a maisonette? Has a maisonette got a balcony?
A maisonette's got an upstairs and a downstairs.
Oh, so it's a flat on two levels?
Yes.
An apartment is...
A big flat.
Is it just bigger? Is it the size?
I think it's just a posh name for a flat, isn't it?
I don't know. I feel like there's got to be a distinction between the two. Do you know what it is? Do you know the distinction? Write it on a postcard and send it to Exploring With Fighters. Right.
15 Preston Road.
Can't say where he lives. I'm guessing that's not where he lives.
No.
Thank God for that. Right.
Got to be a right.
Imagine.
If it were right.
Because
he has moved.
I know. There's a thing, I can't remember what it's called now, where you do that, where you give out someone's details. There's a name for it, and I can't remember what it is. And I don't mean like being a cop.
Being a complete twat.
Yeah. No, there is. And also, have you seen it when the...
Shoot stuff.
When people get swatted. Yeah. When people get swatted. Have you ever seen that?
No.
So people are on live streams, and it happens in America, because it doesn't happen over here. And they basically ring up the police. People ring up the police and say, oh, he's murdering someone in this house. They find out where he lives and murdering someone. And they come with guns and everything and swat them.
Oh, it's like SWAT team.
Yeah.
Special weapons and tactics.
Everybody calls it being swatted.
Oh, right.
So, yeah.
I thought you meant like a drive-by paintball shooting.
No, or like a big fly.
Yeah, a big fly swat comes outside of your car and smacks him off his feet, yeah.
Anyway, let's go this way. Right, so we've just done the intro in the smallest little pantry because we've got something to rest the phone on, like literally just there. But look at this. Andy didn't want to come to this side, did you?
No.
Because the amount of cobwebs that are in here is absolutely disgusting. But there's also loads of tiles. Have you seen all the tiles? Boxes and boxes of tiles. The roof tiles as well, them, aren't they, I think? Like pan tiles.
Looks like it.
I think that were me. Really? Oh, you've got a bruise from last week.
Yeah.
It's yellow.
I know.
It's like smoker's fingers on your head.
Got a smoker's head. You were a lump last week.
Yeah. I know that it hurt you more than you made on. Because you went down with a bang, a proper bang.
Me being a silly twat, torch in one hand, try putting the other. And it, like, I'll drop them.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Put my hands down, and just kept all of them.
No, but you don't think about it, do you, when you do stuff
like
that?
It just happens so quick.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway.
Like that, tripping over that little bit of twig.
I said how small it was in here. Look at this. Look at this little sink. I don't really understand this sink. I think that sink shouldn't be there on top. I think that's the old style sink underneath.
I think so.
No, there's a big bowl underneath there. So if you move that and then the wooden lid, you can't get in, can you? I'm going to move,
yeah.
So then you can do it. There. And I can be looking at these little poison bottles. Here, look. Oh, so I can't even look over here. I've got to just watch you moving a sink. Yeah, this is what I'm saying. Move that. Don't smash it, please. Yeah, if you move that log and then lift that up, I reckon that's the original old-fashioned sink.
Yeah, because of the tap.
Yeah, exactly. That's so good. When do you see them like that anymore?
Carry on. And it's just cold water, so we've heated it up from the bottom.
Oh, yeah, because it's metal, in it. You're not going to fall over the sink, don't worry.
But fall over everything,
isn't it? I knew it. I knew that was the case. So, yeah, you would have put your cold water in there and then heated it with that. That's so good. I saw the thing that made me realise that it was that was the wooden lid, because they used to have the big wooden lids on them, didn't they? But I don't really know why that's there, to be fair.
No, I don't either.
Were you deep in thought then, or what? Are these like little washing machine things?
I think they are.
Oh, is it upside down? That one. How would these work then? You just put them in and... you'd only get about two items of clothes in there.
Well, if it's my washing... Oh, two pair of my missus's knickers.
Oh, you can't say that.
It just jiggles, doesn't it? It don't spin.
Are we talking about your missus? Or are we talking
about... Yeah, she just jiggles.
But yeah, like, there's not really much room in there, is there, at all? No.
See, would one be a washer and one be like a spinner?
Yeah, possibly.
To spin it.
But I can't tell with that one. When's this paper from? Oh, 1986. 23rd of December, 1986. What that about? Oh, basketball.
Bloody hell.
Basketball in London.
Back there, London.
Yeah, let me get over there, because I was looking at them bottles before you rudely interrupted me.
I'll put this back together.
Okay. Oh, yeah, look. Little poison bottle with a little old writing on it as well. I love that. That's so good. And then I don't know what that one is. Look at his tash on the front of that. That's really, really good. But I don't know what... It says Kills Path. Oh, Sloan's Liniment. I'm sure I've heard of Sloan's Liniment before.
Yeah, I have. I've heard the name Sloan's before.
It says Sloan's Liniment kills pa. I'm guessing that's pain. Or not just like...
kills me pa.
Yeah, exactly. Not like your dad or your grandpa. So, look at some of these old pipes, though. Look at the thickness of those. And that there. What's that bit all about? Is it gas-fired? Oh, what? Or is that the where water goes in?
I don't... There's a tap down there.
Yeah, but that's on the pipes behind. That's on there. What's that bit for with the big... Oh, that's like a... Like something would fit on the end of there, look. But I don't understand what that pipe is and why it goes up there. I don't really understand.
I think...
It had the heating fitted up to it somehow.
Look.
Look at the size of that big gas...
That's a water tank.
Not gas. Copper. That's the word I was looking for. Copper tank.
So will that come down, go behind the fire? The fire would heat the water.
Yeah. Yeah, that seems right. It's just that big one there. Because these are the water pipes that go to the water tank. But what is this? I feel like that's gas.
Could be.
But why would it... What is it, a gas-fired... Surely it's not gas fired, is because it's like
can't have been an coal. Addition.
I don't really understand it all. I'm not going to lie. What is Topps silicone cream? Oh, polishes furniture.
Furniture polish.
Yeah. And what's that? Embrocation. Family remedy for muscular rheumatism, lumbago, sciatica, stiffness in joints and muscle neuralgia.
Give me some of that.
Sprains, bruises, excellent pain reliever. Not reviver. You don't want your pain.
Let's revive the pain. let's get rid of it with that. and then we'll revive it.
Bring it back.
Chiropody
sponge. Removes corns, calluses, hard skin, works in minutes.
For you, for your feet.
Are my feet okay? You know, they're quite. You know, actually, though, from running, I used to have. Let's see if I can have a look. Let's look at my feet close up.
Oh.
Look at them little porklets. Yeah, those little marks on my left two toes there are from running. They used to rub away. I used to have to peel it off like hard skin on the tops of my toes, and I used to chew it.
Don't, because I've had a jacket tatus there, and the skin would probably have been like that.
Yeah, I used to do it with the bottom of my feet, though. You know, because I used to run for hours and hours and hours.
Yeah.
They'd go so hard.
Your feet stink.
I know they do, don't they? It's the shoes, it's not the feet. But yeah, I used to run for that long, my feet would go hard, and I'd have to peel the whole of the bottom of my foot off in one go.
You're just wrong.
And eat it like beef jerky. So salty and nice, it was so good. I used to look forward to it, like after road running league, when I'd finished that.
You're just, literally.
It was so nice.
You are literally enough to make a maggot sick, honest to God.
No, but what is wrong? What is wrong with it?
Well, eating your own feet.
Do you bite your nails?
No, I don't really.
Have you ever bitten your nails?
When I was younger.
Have you ever eaten your nails?
No.
Why? What a waste of your effort if you're not going to eat them.
What's it going to give you? Protein, vitamin
yeah,
B?
Yeah, protein. It will have protein.
Protein in my arse to give you... Tell you something, shit your nails out, it'll give you bloody piles.
Give you worms.
Give you a split arse. You better cut you to bits on the way out, like eating razor blades.
No, I liked it. I'm scared, yeah. But yeah, no, I always eat, my nails, are, I'm not even, oh no, well.
No, you've just got stumps.
I can't show you properly, but yeah, I've got no nails at all, because I nervously bite them all the time. But I eat my toenails still as well.
Bend over.
Oh no, I'll just cut them off. What are you doing now? You're desperate to turn this up. Oh, spin dryer. That saves you turning it over then, doesn't it?
That answers the question. One's a washer, one's a dryer.
Yep. Yeah. Right, let's get in here.
Some of that lumbago cream.
Oh, look at it in here. Ooh. It's all a bit, it's a bit like a party in here with these mirrors.
Ooh. Look. Some of them on my bedroom ceiling.
Look at this. It's like a
glitter ball.
Yeah, massive one. What's this? Come and open this book. I want to know what this book is. Hurry up. Wait a minute. A bit quicker than that, mate. Oh, what's it saying here?
New Testament.
Oh, I don't want to read it. I know what it says. I've read it a couple of times. On my lunch.
Yeah, I bet you have.
What we got over here? Ooh. On Her Majesty's Service, National Insurance Act. Oh, this sounds exciting. Ministry of Labour.
No, I'm just laughing at something else I've just seen.
Oh, right. Why, what are you seeing? You need to show me
this newspaper.
Oh, what?
Hitler, abnormal, but not mentally ill. Tell half the Jews that.
You can't say that. Firstly, you can't say that, and they can't say that either. A West German psychiatrist and criminologist has produced a study of Hitler which concludes that the Nazi dictator was psychologically abnormal but not mentally ill or emotionally disturbed. I think he bloody was.
Yeah, some people would completely disagree.
Yeah, definitely. That's mad.
Oh, yeah. What year is that from?
86.
God.
1986. Treasure of the Tsars back on display. You know what interests me about the Tsars? It's a bit of... I know it's not
it's,
really...
It's something that I've never... Don't really know much about the Tsars. The Russian Tsars.
Yeah, they were... Yeah, because they were related to our royal family, though, as well, weren't they?
Were they?
Yeah. Have you heard the story of Anastasia?
Yeah.
That...
I'm out of love.
No!
Set me free.
Not that Anastasia. No. The one, the princess that went missing, that disappeared.
Yeah.
But they murdered the whole family, but she was supposed to have gone somewhere else. But when we went to Russia, we were going to go to that Eggman's house. What's he called?
Fabergé man.
Yeah, Fabergé. And he buried a load of eggs in his garden, apparently. Okay. But that were all, he made all the eggs for the Tsars. And it really interests me.
That's worth an absolute fortune.
And there were that man that were mucky. What were he called? That dirty one. The dirty man that used to hang around with the Tsars. Who were like...
Rasputin. Mental.
Yes, Rasputin. He's really interesting. He, like, didn't he die 7 times or something like that? Something
really weird.
Yeah, he got, like, drowned, stabbed, shot and all sorts and never died. Really odd.
Yeah, Rasputin was a bit weird, right?
Yeah, but I don't understand why the royal family, like, took him under the wing. It was a bit odd.
What did he actually do, Rasputin?
I know he's a bit weird.
He was like an aide, like a... Oh, you know, like a muse is to a musician.
Yes.
He was like that to the...
Oh, okay.
To the Tsar man. Britain's Beautiful Volume. I wonder when these are from, these booklets. I don't think they're very... Oh, that's Italy. That's North Italy. Oh, is that we saw on that hill that we said we were going to go to? We drove up the valley. Do you remember?
No.
Don't you remember?
No.
Maybe it were a different country.
Maybe it were a different person you were with.
No, I think it might have been Romania. I might have got it wrong.
Probably.
When were... I think it were Romania. Romania's a blur now because we were so ill.
I can't remember half of it.
What's this? These are all pages. Montreal. Oh, yeah. Our Canadian viewers. That's what Montreal looked like in 1996, apparently.
Still got horses.
There's one, it's having a TV stand, but then having a TV stand made out of a TV is just taking the piss a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, I remember Sony Trinitron. That's got to be 80s, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Or maybe 90s, but I think it's 80s. Have you noticed there's little candles everywhere? Is that drug use? Yes. It's one of them little gas canisters, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel like somebody's been in here doing paranormal stuff, don't you? Because there's candles all over. What are these things down here? I don't mean the bit of material.
Oh, no, what?
There's like a... What is... Oh, it is a door handle, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's this?
Ashtray.
That's not an ashtray.
It's an ashtray.
It's not very...
Made out of wood.
Why would you make an ashtray out of wood? So it sets on fire.
Ash doesn't stay that lit for very long, does it?
I suppose. Oh, yeah, look. There's more.
Yeah,
someone's been drugging it up in here.
What else? I can feel it.
What are you singing now?
Okay, that'll send you whappy, won't it?
I know. Looks good there. What is that you were just singing?
Living it up.
Yeah, that's just singing it again. That's not actually telling me what it is. What you found down there?
Oh, I thought another book was there.
Oh, it is. All the pages are down there. Right.
Oh, poor old couple have been sat in front here with a little fire.
I don't even know if there were... I reckon there were a gas fire there, look, because there's a plug there. And there were no proper fire in there, were there? What? I don't mean gas, I mean electric.
Oh, wait, that one. There was a gas fire there, and you used to plug it in. I'm just going to wait, because it'll click in a minute.
You know what I mean? I actually quite like that fireplace. Oh, I think it's quite cool, but it's like there's never been a fire there.
No, just for showing.
It is for show.
Yeah.
Wow, what you found? Oh, is it them polar bear men? Mints. Not men. Fox's Glacier Mints. They look quite old.
You said glacier or glacier?
Glacier. Why?
That's a glacier.
It's glacier. Are they in it?
It's heavy, won't it?
Try and open it.
Unless it's somebody else with ashes in there.
Oh, don't. I've thought about Robert all week. It's wrong. People were saying that we should have... Don't just give up. I want a bit more effort than that.
What effort are you going to get?
Come on.
Literally.
No, I was thinking, like, people were saying we should have told someone about Robert.
Did we?
Who?
The 13,400 people that watched it.
No, I mean, we should have told someone official to come and get him. Like, people saying, oh, yeah, just tell his family. I don't know who he is.
Could be anybody.
Could be Robert. Right.
It's the family's bloody.
Yeah, whoever's left him behind. It's wrong though, isn't it? What's this?
From Berlin to Congo.
Ooh, countries of the world. Oh, it's just countries of the world. Although Berlin's not a country. Not last time I looked.
No, not really.
What are you doing with that book?
I don't know, it's just full of bits.
Oh, there's two. Is that volume? What's this one?
Aberystwyth to Bengal. I know that says Abyssinia.
Is that what it's Abyssinia? Yeah.
Where is Abyssinia?
I've got no idea. It probably don't exist anymore, does it?
What were thingy before? Nigeria or something like that. Oh, Ethiopia.
Ethiopia.
I'm not sure. That had another name, didn't it?
Yeah. Somebody will tell us.
Was it Addis Ababa?
Oh, no, that's Addis Ababa.
Is that the capital or something? Or is that a different country altogether?
That's the capital of something else, isn't it?
I don't know. Addis Ababa.
Dabadi dabadai.
Come on. Oh, look. A Samoria. Just in case you didn't manage to get your washing done in there, you can do it in here. Where are we going now?
I'm buying some that big one.
I know. Oh, God. Oh, look at it in here. Got a little telly. Oh, you shone your torch into that little alcove there, and it made me jump.
How can I shine it?
Shine it this way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shine it.
I am.
Well, that lit up. There, you look.
Oh, there.
Yeah. I saw that out of the corner of my eye and it made me jump. Oh, look at this. Oh, it literally says, look, BBC One, BBC Two, Italian TV One, Italian TV Two. Murphy.
Before Channel 4 came along then.
Murphy, 20-inch single standard. 20-inch would have been big for them days though, wouldn't it? Don't say a word. I know what's going through your brain, you dirty man.
When did Channel 4 come? 1984 or something?
Yeah, we're in my lifetime.
So that's...
But what? We're ITV.
ITV's always been ITV.
Yeah, but why does it say ITA?
I don't know.
I don't understand.
Independent Television Authority.
Is that what it stands for? You've just made that up, haven't you?
Yeah.
I thought so. What does ITV stand for?
Don't know.
Independent television. Oh, television, yeah. Oh, it could be, to be fair. Right, let's have a look. This is from High Street Tutbury, and it's some little tablets. This is poison, not to be taken. Why would you have it then? That bottle's really good. Turn it round. So green. Look how green that is. I always thought they were in blue bottles, poison.
It can be on any as long as it's got the ribs yeah. for your pleasure.
Not just shove it up your arse, are you?
Yeah, so if people with partially sighted can just feel it, right, that's I'm not going to take that, that's going to kill me.
Yeah, but what's it for?
I don't know.
If you have poison and it's not to be taken, what do you do with it? Literally, what do you do with it? Are you going to answer me what you do with it?
I don't know.
Oh. What's that? Sniff it. Don't die. What's it? Look at the little measurements on the side. Oh, teaspoon. Oh, they're teaspoon marks, look. That's cool. Turn it around so I can see what it is. No, not so I can see what... Oh, is there no label on it?
Nothing on it.
All right.
It just smells like really strong piss.
I thought you were going to say really strong vinegar or really strong... No. Not piss.
So, somebody just needs to drink a bit more water. Oh, it's like that. Place in Leeds that we went to, and a bottle of wine or something, and I sniffed it in that worst piss.
Somebody been pissing in a wine bottle,
put it in a drawer,
and then you went to smell it. Good job you didn't have a gulp first. Do you remember that place in Russia? What were you going to say? What?
Well, last week or week before, a fan had switched a goalkeeper's drink for piss.
Really?
Yeah.
What, at the World Cup or no, just in general?
I think it was some sort of lower league or Sunday league or something.
So bad.
He went and swapped it and pissed in it and he drunk it.
That's really bad. Do you remember in Russia, though, that bottle that I was like, oh, shall I drink this? And it turned out to be fucking acid or something. People, like, worked out what it said. Strength tablets? What's a strength tablet?
Steroids.
A marvellous pick-me-up and restorative after... Excitement. Oh, excitement?
Right. They're Viagra. I'm having them away. Well, there's none in it.
Oh. No, but...
You had too much excitement, they died.
After excitement, though, when would you ever say that in a sentence? After excitement, overwork and depression.
Why would you want to... Still hear something.
Do you know coming through trees?
Yeah, I heard a noise. That was really weird.
Unless there's another way around from back, which is clear, but we had to get some scamper stools and trees to get here, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. Oh, it's made me go funny, that has. Yeah, look at the oil lamp as well. Big old oil lamp. You don't often see it, like, you see the bits of glass, but then they're like somewhere else. They're never put together like that.
Quite good, that.
Yeah, it is. It would be good, like, cleaned up, repainted, because that colour's wank.
You need to polish up that, not even painted. Just put dust in it.
What do you mean polished up? It's painted anyway. It's painted. It's not metal.
I've got metal.
Well, it is probably metal, but underneath the paint. I was just looking at this fireplace. I thought I liked the tiles, but I don't think I do anymore. What do you think? I think they're like, are they like 60s, 70s edition?
You're surrounded on this.
Yeah, I can see. Big massive one round there. But, oh look, a little record player down there. In fact, what is this? What is that for? What is, it's, that's like a HMV sign, isn't it? Yeah. His master's voice. Oh, in fact, it says the Gramophone Company Limited. I'll try and focus that. Registered trademark. That's not what. That's HMV's trademark thing, isn't it?
No, I thought it was a yo-yo.
It does look like a yo-yo.
It's not. It's got like a
fuzzy felt.
Fuzzy felt.
Oh. You're rubbing it off.
It's got mange.
Yeah, just turn it back over though. Like, is that before HMV, do we think? Because his master's voice, that's what that was. That's why it says HMV, isn't it? Because that's what the dog's doing, listening to his master's voice on a gramophone. That's
weird. Just sort of lighting to that window.
All right. But yeah, it definitely says, I'll try and do it so you can see it. There we go. The Gramophone Company Limited registered trademark. But that is definitely HMV. So why? Is it predated, do you think?
Could be.
But what's it for? Does it open?
No. I think that is to clean records.
Really? Oh, yeah, that would get all the dust out. All the dust off. You'd think it'd scratch it, though, but I suppose if that were really soft. It'd
been velvet.
Yeah. Originally. Oh, that would make sense, because that's why it's all coming off.
Yeah.
But that's weird. I'm going to have a look at that in a minute. See what it is.
Yeah,
see
if it was Ferguson or whatever it is.
Ferguson?
What do you say?
HMV. Ferguson's that.
No, what are you saying? That?
That's going to stink. That's for it. Where are you going? They don't smell that bad. Come on over here. No. I want to show you in this corner here. No, just come here a minute. No. Come on.
No.
Oh, look, it's amazing. Look down here. Look at it.
No, because you're moving away from it and you're lifting that.
No, it's that. Look at that.
No, because you've got your arse stuck
out. No, honestly, it's amazing. Come on. No. You haven't even seen it.
I'm not going to see it.
Come on.
You can't see it from the cloud of shite.
There's nothing, like, it doesn't even smell. Come on.
Do you know when people say that, it doesn't even smell? You know it's going to smell, but you walk up with. Don't you?
You do.
You can't help yourself.
No, but look, come over. Don't even smell. There's no odour to it at all.
You're going to do another one,
right? I'm not.
It's fusty smell here. It's fusty. It
does smell. There's nothing in the corner either. Some pieces of glass.
It's lumpy, that.
Oh, it burnt a bit on the way out, that. I don't think farts are supposed to burn.
Yours do.
Look at all the books in there. Don't you think this is a weird setup? Have you noticed a couple of things? Just shut the doors 2 seconds. Let me show you something. Right. Above this door here, have you noticed there's a light there?
Yeah.
But it services this side of the door and this side of the door, which I think is quite ingenious. And there's another one there above your head. I feel like there should have been another one in there as well. That they were going to put one in there, don't you think?
I don't see the point of having one there.
What, in a cupboard?
Yeah.
I suppose it doesn't make sense to have one in a cupboard. But when, look at all these books. They all look really old as well. No, but, no, I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying. They're all coat hangers under there, yeah? Would that originally not have been there? I feel like this doesn't match. There's something wrong. Don't you think there's something wrong? Is that plaster? No, but look at the wood. It's like newer wood, isn't it?
Yeah. I must have panelled it out for whatever reason.
Oh, just tap on the back. Is it solid wall?
Yeah. I think it's all like that one.
Yeah.
Most of it knocked back.
Oh, God, I know. No, it just doesn't seem right, though. There's something not quite right.
What's the point in having a door leading to a brick wall?
Yeah, exactly.
Might just panel it.
It just doesn't... There's something off with this house. Like there's something hidden away somewhere.
Something off about your house.
I'm sure there's plenty more to come as well.
Oh, don't.
Look at the... Oh, is that Eisel? Is it Eisel? Look at it.
Colour.
Yeah, that sort of brown tip. Oh, don't notice it's hanging down. Yeah. Oh, I remember that on your bum hole.
It's softer than what it used to be, though.
Is it?
Yeah.
I can't feel that. Rigid. Hold that. Oh, yeah, it's sort of halfway between Eisel and normal toilet paper. I wonder if there was like a crossover period between softness and ripped arsehole.
It's been used to scrunch it. It used to be sharp, didn't it? Are you a scrunch or a folder?
Folder.
Folder.
Definitely a folder.
Got to be a folder. Anybody who scrunches the toilet roll and tries to wipe their arse with it, there's something wrong with him.
I wrap it round my hand, and then I take my hand out of it, and then you do it. So I'm more of a roller.
No.
No, it's only the same as folding it.
No, no, but it just seems too much faff.
No, because think about it. Yeah, that's like it. That. No, whereas you fold, think about how you fold it.
Just fold it.
Yeah.
A couple of squares, fold it.
A couple?
Put it down, a couple more.
I would say that I have at least 15 squares per wipe.
The size of your ass.
No. My bumhole's only the same size as everybody. You don't get a bigger bumhole if you're fat. You know that. So, what we got in here? You can't say that. There's been no pegging going on in my life. Thank you very much. Oh, look at this bed. Proper sprung bed. Bread, sprung bread.
Sprung bread.
It's like a bread cake with springs. Get on it. Have a lie down.
There's been a pegging coming.
There will be no pegging. And pegging doesn't involve two men. Well, I suppose it could, but...
Of course it could.
No, because it's got a, it's involving a...
Oh, snap on.
Yeah, exactly. So maybe...
No, it's just bumming.
Yeah, bumming is bumming and pegging is pegging. There's people out there that have no idea what we're talking about.
This is going to collapse. Isn't it?
Please don't let it collapse.
It's going to fall in.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is...
Get yourself... Why didn't you take your bag off first? You're like a hunchback now. Don't get back off.
I'm not moving on.
Do you think it would have been comfortable?
It would have been a mattress on it.
What mattress is down there? Do you want me to get it for you?
God, that's some rough sex, that, isn't it?
You get some right chunks. Is that it?
Yeah.
I wanted you to put your head down.
I'm not putting my head down. I'm not getting my head trapped in the spring. It's not happening, is it?
It's cold.
No matter what else.
Oh, not a great deal in here, though, is there? But yeah, look. Candles. There's been definitely something demonic going off in here. What is, oh, look, it's got the little maker's thing. This is good. It's, what's it say? The Excelsior's mattress and seating. Charlton trademark. I can't read that other side of it, but that's really good. The Excelsior's.
Chipping Bird Graveyard, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. Half a bird down there. I noticed this one as I walked in. Little skull. I don't know what sort of bird that is, you know. Look at its beak.
Would it be a crow?
No, I don't think it's a crow.
No, its beak's too small, isn't it, for a crow?
Yeah, but it looks like a little bit of a lethal beak, that. It's not a pigeon. I don't know what it is.
Don't know. See all the books?
Oh, what are these? Oh, Russia. Sunday Times. The Sunday Times books. Germany. I used to love things like this when I was younger. Reading through those sorts of stuff. Well, looking at pictures. Britain. India. You're getting tired yet? France. Israel. Tropical Africa.
And?
Brazil.
Brazil, that's it. That's all you get.
Yeah, not looking through them, but no. I did like stuff. Did you used to watch, oh, what was that programme with that woman that, with a dead daughter?
What, she had a dead daughter sitting out next to her?
No, an Irish dead daughter. She had an Irish dead daughter. She were an Irish woman. And she used to bugger off on holiday and then we used to have to watch it. What were it called? I wish you were here.
Judy Chalmers?
Yeah, with a dead daughter.
She didn't have a dead daughter.
She did have a dead daughter, well, a dead Irish daughter. She used to be on Blue Peter or something, I think. And she was dead.
Are you sure?
What do you mean, am I sure?
To be sure, to be sure.
I don't. Is she Irish?
No.
Well, it's not her then. It was the Irish one.
Judy Chalmers is not Irish.
No, the one that's Irish. Which one was that?
What
about? It was a travel programme with an Irish woman. She was Irish. What was it called? The woman, I mean. What were her name?
I don't know.
And she had a dead daughter.
Did she die of cot death?
No, she was like in her 30s or 40s. I feel like she was murdered. She might have been murdered. She either had cancer or murdered. I can't remember. It was cancer or murdered. I think it might have been murdered. It was... No, what was the woman called that was...
The woman called the travel programme, her daughter that died. She either murdered or she had cancer. She could have been murdered.
She were Irish.
She might not even be Irish. She might have been English.
No, she was definitely Irish. Because her daughter were Irish.
So I don't know what you mean.
She were, she got a weird voice, a weird accent.
She were Irish. Can you remember the travel programme?
Wish you were here.
I can't remember Judy Chalmers doing that.
It might have been her. Did she have a dead
daughter? She had a dead daughter who were Irish and she was murdered. She was blown up.
Oh my God. What was she called though? Was it Judith Chalmers? We need
it's
to
not Judith Chalmers.
We need to look. We need to. I'm sure she's a Blue Peter presenter. I mean.
Not Peter Purvis, is it?
No.
Or Peter Pervert?
No.
I need to change the bathroom.
I've just noticed there's a big ladder behind you up to the attic. I'm going to say cellar. Oh, Lord. That's made me go weird. That I'm going to have to find out now.
It's not
Judith
Chalmers. Gloria Honeyford.
Gloria Honeyford! That was the one.
She is Irish.
And did she have a dead daughter?
Yes.
What was she dead of?
Just died. She just stopped breathing.
Well, no, I know.
Heart stopped, blood stopped, brain dead.
Weren't it like a stalker murder?
Oh, I don't know.
I'm sure she had a stalker that murdered her or something like that. I might be making this bit up. I might be mixing two stories together.
You might be.
Oh, look at that. Is that a bow tie?
Right.
A bow tie. Hung up over the edge of there. Is a bow tie that?
It is.
Can you tie it?
No. I can't tie a tie properly.
You can't tie a tie? What is wrong with you?
I can, in a fashion.
Well, that is fashion.
But not like...
Windsor?
Windsor knot. I have to follow instructions on my phone.
Really?
Yeah, because I can't remember which way to tie
it. Can you tie a tie on yourself?
Yes.
Oh. So you're all right tying it. Can you tie it on someone else?
Yes.
Is it where you go round, 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 up and down and through?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. I think I used to have to tie them all the time.
I used to wear the shirt and tie all the time for work, single day.
There's something wrong with your face today. It keeps going, look, wait a minute. It's very reflective. Like you've got a very, the torture's making it go weird. You've got to look like you're dancing in background now with your head. Oh, like you're shagging it background. Look at, proper going for it over there. Right, I need to make a public apology. I feel really bad she did die of cancer, not of murder. What are you doing with that? Yeah, she died of breast cancer. Who am I thinking about that died of murder?
Died of murder?
No, but someone else died of murder. Who is it?
Well, there's loads of people.
No, but who... got stalked and stabbed on the doorstep.
That was Jill Dando.
Jill Dando. She was the murdered one.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't feel
the door and she got stabbed.
I don't feel as bad now.
Oh, she was lovely. Yeah.
At least someone were murdered. No, that sounds even worse.
She, I thought she was beautiful, me, Jill Dando.
I don't remember what she looked like. I just remember the name. It must have been in the 90s, that.
I think so.
Get it on. Put it on.
Let's get it on.
Oh, in fact, there's another hat on there. Put this one on first. But the other one, it reminds me of something that's Christmas related.
This reminds me of a Sunday school teacher.
How does it? Come on, stop just shaking. Bloody blinding me. You're not supposed to have that little loop sticking out of your head. Who do you look like on there?
John Wayne.
Benny Hill. Ooh, yeah. No, put that on. That hat looks like someone's hat. No, I mean, someone related to Christmas. Just put it on.
So related to Christmas?
Yeah.
Mary?
No, put it on. And then you need to look like him that's on telly when you do it. Put it on. Just put it on.
It's like Guess Who's Dead.
He's not dead, he's a knobhead.
Yeah, but you need to look like him.
Piers Morgan. You need to put it on and then look like Piers.
Nobody can look like a twat like that.
Put it on, I told you you were a knobhead.
What, your feet on my head?
There we go. Now if you look like Piers Morgan, if you look, put your head forward a little bit. If you look like Piers Morgan, you'd look like that woman at her Home Alone with the pigeons.
Yeah.
It's the same hat.
Pigeon lady.
I swear she's got that hat.
Yes.
And you'd look, if you look like Piers Morgan, it basically would be the same person.
Yeah, but I don't.
But you don't, no.
I don't like Piers Morgan.
No, I don't think many people do. Let's have a look. Oh, look at this. Oh, it's the Ordnance Survey map of Bedford and Cambridge. I wonder what year that's from. Look at the picture of the car on it. Is it like 20s or 30s, that? Oh, I thought it was like a book, but obviously it's a map. It will say the year on there, surely. Open it up. Oh, see, does it say on the back? Put it down. Turn it round. No, other way. Thank you. That's the way I wanted.
Do you want my thumb?
Yeah. No, it doesn't say it. Okay. Can you try and find it somewhere else? It's got to say a year on it, sure. Oh, there. Turn it round. Turn it round. Turn it round. Turn it. Not fold it up. 1927. Says it there, look. 1st of January, 1927.
Here you go.
Said it was 20s, 30s, didn't I?
Yeah.
Getting good at this old aging lark. What's this? It can't be that old. It's got London Underground on it. 1939. Oh, saying that, London Underground's been there a long time, hasn't it?
Quite a few years, hasn't it?
Yeah, that's good. Shite. No, but it's still quite old. So, self-opening memo tablet.
Not because it closes. How's that work? It's supposed to go this way.
What's it for, though? It says, easily removes from the tablet by using a damp cloth. What? What does that mean?
Just rip it out. It's damp cloth.
Pencil notes are easily removed from... Oh! Oh, you can write in it and wipe it off. It's reusable.
Alright. Whatever.
I think that's what it means. Oh, this is from 1923. It's from Screwfix. Yeah, Screwfix Direct. Nettleford's Screw Department Catalogue, 1923. Brass roundhead wood screws. Okay. Fucking, this is the most boring book in the world.
This is bedtime reading.
Yeah, look. Mild steel countersunk head Whitworth cut thread machine screws. Bloody hell, that's a long enough name. Milled?
Mild steel.
It says mild. I feel like it should be milled.
No, it's mild steel.
I know how you spell milled, but that just, it should have been in my head. Brass washers. Mild steel. Why is it mild?
Because it's not hard steel, it's soft steel.
Why would you want that?
I don't know.
Because that's going to bend when you screw it in, innit? What are you doing now? What is this?
Fucking hell.
It's got some, is it a brush? Oh, it actually works quite well.
It's heavy.
Yeah. got some proper brushes on the bottom of there. What else we got in here anyway? Oh, look. Churchman's Penny Library. Churchman's Handy Dictionary. One penny. Well, that, I suppose that makes sense. What is it?
It's a dictionary, isn't it?
A dictionary? But I don't feel like it's big enough. You just get a certain selection. Is it just A in this one? Oh, no, it's got C. I don't understand why it would be that small.
No, no, it's a dandy dictionary. I'm a dandy highwayman.
Oh, weirdo. Fry's Pure Concentrated Cocoa.
Fry's Turkish Delight.
Oh, yeah, Fry's Turkey. I like
it. Chocolate.
I like it, mate. Do you like it?
No.
Come here a minute.
Not here, mate.
No, that bruise on your head suddenly got bigger.
That's a tumour.
Oh, no, it's dirt. You've got dirt on your head.
I've just got a brain tumour.
Turn around. Other way.
No.
No, I promise you I'm not going to do anything. I'm just
going to smack you right in
the face. I promise you I'm not doing anything to you. No, look, you've got dirt. Oh, fucking hell, I thought you could have hurt me then.
I can't see anything.
No, honestly, you've got dirty marks on your head.
That'd be right.
The Hound of the Gods. What's this brown? Oh, the People of the Mist.
Oh.
He likes his books, doesn't he?
Loads of them, isn't
there? Shall we go up those ladders? Have a look what's up there.
Yeah, have we done all the rest down here?
I think we have. Like I said, with it being a bungalow, and it's quite... Well, it's not small, is it? But it's not massive. Oh, cupboards. What's in these cupboards? I looked in these.
Shit roll.
Boots, double top. Hey, I wonder if... Is that the Eisel stuff? Turn it over, because I think it's been opened from the bottom.
That's like it.
I think it is. So boots, double top. Must have been the precursor to normal.
Yeah.
What is that?
Pembritin.
Pembritin.
Broad spectrum antibiotic.
Mm. What's in there? Come on, muscles.
Nothing.
What do you mean, nothing?
Nothing. Just shelve that.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Why it's can't stuck. You get in it there?
You stuck or stuckered.
That's weird. I do like the old switches.
I do.
Let me have a look. I never looked actually in here properly. And a big bath and sink. Why? Oh, would that be towels?
Yeah.
You put your towels up on here.
Or robes.
What's happening up floor?
Did that just be old bath mat?
Did it? And that's just rope. Oh, it's those. I could never work out those taps.
I love them taps.
They're weird, aren't they? We've seen them somewhere else before. Where it comes out of the bottom like that. Really weird.
Top, are they?
Well, no, but I mean, they don't come out like a loop bit.
Oh, like a...
Yeah, exactly.
I like them, I prefer them.
I do. Although Americans will call them a faucet.
Bloody faucet.
I like this toilet with the big wooden seat. Anyway, let's get up. Look at these ladders. These ladders are pretty cool, to be fair, aren't they? Big metal... Oh, does it pull up somehow? I don't feel like we should pull it up, but...
No.
Is that what that big metal bar is up the middle for? Because it looks like it's got a chain like, on it. Like on a bike, on the back of it. Try not to walk into stuff. Right, get up then. Get yourself up those stairs. You can watch out, because it's not very wide. Look. Back to the Andy Bum Appreciation Society. Definitely look good in those bottoms, Andrew.
I look good without them as well.
Oh, God, no. Right, coming up. Not up your bottom. Oh, I thought it was just going to be like this. Just like a water tank. And then just a bit of an empty space. But there's doors after both sides. So, no idea what's in these.
Three-legged stool.
I thought you meant like a milking stool type thing. What are you doing? What are you, Michael Flatley?
I hate Michael Flatley.
Why?
His legs move independently of the rest of his body. There's something wrong with him. Literally. I does it?
Don't you trust a man whose legs move like that?
No. Not at all.
What we got down here? Oh, is that another... Is that those things again? That we're looking at other week.
Oh, macaroni balls.
They look like them. In fact, what are all these things down here?
Oh, they're nibs. Get a nib. I don't want to go anywhere near the buttons, that's why I'm asking you to do it.
Oh, God.
Yeah, look, writing nibs. Turn it over so can, I think it's got writing on the writing nib. I can't see it down there. I'll have to pick it up and bring it up here. Let's have a look. Oh, I can't get it to focus on it. Oh, there we go. Oh, it's wrong way up. That's why I can't read it. Let's turn it round. It says review. I can't get it. Review pen, Birmingham. I can't read that word on that side. Granddad and co. I can't read it. It's really hard to read that because it reflects funny.
That's small.
Yeah. But yeah, there's loads of them down there, look. And other bits of stuff. And then those bulbs. Are that? Do you say they are Marconi, those?
No, they're not Marconi old ones.
Are they not?
No.
Oh, old tennis racket. I reckon that's 1930s, you know. Let me see if there's a make on it. That says Mondeo. Turn it over. Ford, I think. I can't...
I died.
Let me go this way. It says Keaton and Co. There's something. Oxford, London. I know Oxford's not in London, but I reckon that's 1930s, that. Definitely.
Quite a wide handle, that. You've got to have, like, pretty big hands.
Yeah. But it's different to a normal tennis racket, like a new tennis racket, that, isn't it?
Yeah. More oval.
Yeah. Yeah, the shape's different on it, definitely. Oh, what is this, Andy? What is this? For a start, what is that? Is that an aerial? Looks like a star off on the top of a shit tree from 1986.
Like a sail.
It's weird. But yeah, look at this radio thing here. What is this all about? It says Igranic components. And then it says, oh God, I can't really read it. Something Electric Co. Limited. It's, why would it be made by an electric company? Oscillator, isn't that something to do with electric?
I thought an oscillator was like something that would beep, 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 beep. You know, like...
I don't know. It says oscillator filament, oscillator vernier, strength. It is, it's something to do with electric, this. Amplifier filaments, switch, two. Oh no, that could be something to do with radio then.
I thought it'd be radio. But it's not. No speakers or anything, is
there? Well, no, but what's this bit here, look?
It's like, oh, well.
No, it's like numbers on the top though. Like you put it on a certain setting. I don't understand it, what it is. I feel like it is a radio because it says tone. And oh, that's a loudspeaker.
Oh, it must have a speaker somewhere.
Yeah, amplifier filaments. Does it open at the top? I feel like it's hinged. Ah, what is this?
That's a very, very, very old radio if it is.
Look at that. They're so weird.
They just...
It's Bakelite, isn't it? Don't bounce them about, they'll break. It says self-stabilizing reactance unit. Self-stabilizing reactance unit. That's baffled me, that.
Like how they just...
Stop bedoinging them. But what is this bit for here? Like, why do they move inside? When you, yeah, look, when you turn that, it does that.
I've got no idea.
I have no idea what that is. Oh my God, is that a warhead? That looks like a bloody warhead. Have a look at...
projectile missile.
It's heavy. Oh. Heavier than you think, isn't it? What's that for? It like screws into something.
Yeah.
It's like a bloody warhead. I know it's not. That's what it... Ooh, another one. A round warhead. Another one there as well.
It's like...
Seems so.
The thing that the landing when they come from outer space.
Yeah, exactly. What are they? Is there any writing? Oh, there's some measurementy things on it. Like numbers round it. 17, 18, 19. Yeah, it's just numbers all around it. Oh, wait. It says I can't read it. One of 39 or something. I can't. I'm not sure.
Weird anyway, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just really hard. I don't understand what either of those things are. And I certainly don't understand that radio thing. Fucking hell. I thought I was going through the floor then. Oh my God, my stomach turned then properly bad. What's this piece of paper as well? Royal Society for the Encouragement of Art. What, so they just stood there clapping, going, nice picture. Well done, son.
You have a degree.
Of Arts, Manufactures and Commerce, London, founded 1754, incorporated 1847. Herbert, is it Parcel? Of the Municipal School of Commerce, Derby, 1922. And it's for first class in arithmetic. That's good. I like finding stuff like that.
So we can add up, big deal.
You can add up and then use this weird machine and then bomb someone. What else? Is there anything underneath that? Is there any, I can see like books and stuff. Oh, look at that picture. It's not painted there, that is it? Well, it might be, but it's not the original.
Yeah.
Oh, what is this? Oh, it's his name, look. You know, the guy that was just on that then is written on the top of there. Novello's Pocket Edition, Handel's Otario, The Messiah. Isn't that music? Oh, yeah, Handel is music, isn't it? Yeah, book of music. The Beggar's Opera, written by Mr. Gay. News Chronicle, Gardening Month by Month. So he liked it, a wide range of different stuff. I don't know what this is. This looks quite good. Oh, look. Oh, Herbert Thomas Parnell, born November.
Is it Parnell or Powell?
I can't, I'm not sure. Married Lizzie Large on the 22nd. Herbert John, born August 3rd, 1905. Edith, born 1906. So it's got all the names in here of like the family.
Don't want to be the like little family tree.
Yeah, but what I don't know what the book is. Just open the next page for me.
What's it say on the side?
You can't hardly see it. Oh, it's the Bible. It's a family Bible. Oh, that's sad, isn't it?
Oh, I can't open this page. Oh.
So the latest child was born 111 years ago. Yeah, 1835, that Bible is from. That's mad. Oh. What a shame to think that they wrote that in there thinking it would be passed down to another family member and then it's left in this. It's so sad. It really, really is. And then we've got some sort of massive bird's nest. Look at that old plug socket. Although saying that, it's a modern...
3-pin, isn't it? You got the round bit at the top.
Yeah. What else we got? Oh,
Bomber Command.
Bomber Command, what's that? My back's broken. Oh, is it from World War II? Oh, it's seen better days, hasn't it? Oh, that's a shame. Oh, showing where all the bombs were dropped and stuff. Look at that. Shift that a minute, because I was just looking at this. Look, calendar for 1905. Turn this over a minute. I feel like there's something on the other side of it. Oh, there is. Is it off like a box of chocolates or something? Copyright 1904. And like, you got a box of chocolates at Christmas and then inside it, it's got, you get a free calendar as well. You just rip it out. That's what I feel like it is.
When the copyright started, couldn't be 1904, could it?
Well, it must have been, otherwise it won't fucking say it on it, you silly fool.
Snake.
Ah!
Exactly, that's my point. It wouldn't see it, would it? If it hadn't started. What else? Is there anything else down there?
The battered bride.
That doesn't say the battered bride. It says the bartered bride. Bloody battered bride. What are they? What are they though, these books?
Operas.
Oh, are they?
Santa and Delilah.
Oh, he likes his opera then, does he?
He does.
What else? There's loads of like books down
there. Fantastiques.
I'd love to go through all these things because I think they're really interesting. You know, like showing a different point in time. Like some of them are old books, but some of them are like talking about certain things. East of Malta, Suez Canal, His Majesty's Minesweepers.
I bet we're in war.
Maybe. Well, it would make sense. Oh, saying that though, if he was born in 1900, I don't know. Oh, he was married in 1905. He would have been in the First World War, wouldn't he?
Yeah, possibly Second. No.
No. Yeah, he would have been too old for Second World War, definitely. Right, let's go and have a look through the other side. So, what we got in here? Does that actually work?
Yeah.
How do you get locked in here? That is something I worry about all the time, going into an abandoned building and getting locked in. Oh.
You would get locked in.
You wouldn't get out, would you?
I'd kick it in.
You wouldn't kick it in. Well, I suppose you'd have to, or you'd ring someone. Oh, look, what's that? What are they called now? I can't remember the name of it. What are they? The... Summit Squares.
Set Square.
Set Square, is that it? Is that what they're called? It's not just a bit of a bed, is it?
Because they put that on the side, don't they?
Oh, yeah.
Right there.
Yeah, but what is it?
Just drive...
Is it just to draw lines?
Yeah.
Or to find a corner?
Find an angle.
Yeah.
90-degree angle, but keep it straight as well.
Would you do it on a wall or just do it on a bit of paper? Oh, would you?
I think so.
I have seen them before.
I'm sure we used to do stuff like this at school.
Oh, we didn't. We definitely didn't.
Made out of wood.
We made stuff out of wood, but I remember we had to do this thing where we sucked some plastic inside it. And like my mum's still got it now.
Is she?
Yeah. I can't remember what that was called. Sucky plastic.
Sucky plasticky thing.
Yeah. What else we got? Look at that! Is that a plunger?
God almighty, if it is.
It's not. It's metal though. Oh, is it for a washer?
Oh, yeah. Like a dolly peg type.
Is that what they call? Are they called dolly pegs?
No, dolly pegs had three legs on it.
Yeah, but what are they called then?
I don't know.
I don't know what they... Oh, look, yeah, because all the water pushed up through those holes. And then...
So they use for washing, it's a very, very large Dalek.
Exterminate. But yeah, I don't think there's... Oh, there's another one of these, look. Oh, God!
Oh, state of that.
Look at all these cobwebs and they're all in my hair. Oh, that's horrible. I'll have to bend down now. Yeah, it's another one of these for Herbert. Herbert Parvel, Parcel, whatever he's called. But this one's a certificate for arithmetic. 1921. What was the date for the other one? Was it before or after 21? He's obviously got his maths more than once. Yeah, don't fall down there. Yeah, was that 1921, that one, or not?
1922.
Oh, so he's passed his maths twice.
May 1922.
Yeah. So I'm guessing that's when he... Oh, no, it can't be when he were at school. Oh, go into that book, into the Bible. Which one was Herbert? Was Herbert one of the children? Oh, no, Herbert. Oh, was born.
November. Didn't say when.
Oh, yeah, but it says born and then it says married. Oh, yeah, he was born in November.
It said...
But that makes no sense.
Herbert John Parrell, born August 3rd, 1965.
Oh, that's the son. I reckon there was... Yeah, Herbert Thomas and then Herbert John. So is this Herbert... Yeah, this is Herbert John, look. Herbert J. So it's the son. So the son was born in 1905 and then he went to school. That would have made him 16.
Oh, I read that's 1965.
1965? Are you off your nut? So his dad... Oh, you're crazy.
I know, it's my eyes.
Yeah, so he was 1905.
Yeah.
So then in 1922, he was 17.
Yeah, so that make it about right.
And yeah, and then the other one, he was 16.
Quite brainy, then.
Why?
Don't know.
What, because he could pass his maths?
Because he had up.
No, but to be fair, though, he was at Municipal School of Commerce in Derby. I wonder if that's the same. Oh, God, I feel like I'm just running between the two here. I don't know why I didn't just pick it up and bring it with me. That would have made more sense, wouldn't it, really? Let's have a look. Yeah, same school. So, yeah, I'm guessing that's like a college or something similar. Anyway, I think we're about done. Yeah, it will have been college, won't it? Oh, you brought it through?
Yeah.
Oh, just done another little squeaky fart.
That went squeaky.
So just a minute, I just need to just
push, no, because
push it's this way a little bit into those comments. Oh dear. So yeah, they are. You've walked into the fart instead now. Oh, that's... Oh Lord. Yeah, so they are pretty much the same. Oh, this is the commercial examinations intermediate stage. This is the commercial examinations advanced stage. So he's gone on to
bigger and better things.
2+2 instead of 1+1 now.
Where's gone from his addition to his times table, his multiplication.
Yes, exactly.
That's what it was.
Right, let's get out of here then. Right. So I keep getting in trouble for saying right, so I say right so too much.
Right. Start of every sentence, yeah. Every intro. Right. Every outro.
So, and I keep having to cut it out though because it's doing my head in because I've noticed it now and I never used to notice it until people have pointed it out.
Done the case.
Yeah. It was good in that it's a shame there wasn't more stuff.
Yeah.
I feel like it had been emptied a little bit, but the stuff that was in there was really good. That's why I wanted more. It kept me wanting more. That radio thing.
That's weird.
Really weird. I really, really am looking forward to somebody telling me what that is because it's interesting. God. Big white van. I thought it was like a riot van, police van type thing then coming past. What else were there? Something else. Those warhead things. Obviously, they're not off bombs, I don't think. But what would they be for? I don't understand.
They're quite weighty.
Yeah, very.
Screw on.
It were almost like concrete at the end of them, weren't it?
Yeah. I wonder if it's some sort of, I don't know.
I have no idea. That's the only thing it made me think of, like off a bomb, but it can't be that, surely. Anyway, let us know if you know. If you haven't had a chance to watch the second channel new series, not new series anymore really, a series that's not finished yet, the £150 car, make sure you do. We've got some good videos coming up on the second channel as well. Well, good ideas in my head. They actually hadn't been filmed yet, but they will be soon. So anyway, you have a lovely rest of your day.
Yes.
And we will see you soon.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.